Merry meet. Welcome to the Moonstruck Cauldron. I wanted to talk to y'all today about calendula. Calendula is marigolds, basically. We're going to talk about correspondences for calendula. And yeah, we'll jump right in. So, from Llewellyn's Complete Book of Correspondences, Marigold corresponds with the zodiac of Cancer and Leo. Its day is Sunday. Its elements are both air and fire. That's cool. Energy is yang, so masculine energy. The solar system is the sun, which, I mean, look at this bright, beautiful yellow. Of course it's the sun. Celebrations are Beltane and Mabon, which would make sense. You know, Beltane is typically the time of year where a lot of flowers are starting to bloom. So that would make sense. And Mabon, of course, is when most things are harvested. So that would be the time where you would probably find a lot of dried marigold. But I'm sure you could grow it and make it yourself throughout the year. Of course, you know, that's always a wonderful magic witchy practice, and I plan on doing that more myself. I'm going to be planting some marigold actually for my magical use, so I plan on getting seeds and plants and putting my intention into it every step of the growth process, so that I can bring about the intentions that I have while using calendula. So that brings me to back to the Book of Correspondences, the issues, intentions, and powers. There's a lot here, guys. The afterlife, affection, authority, awareness, business, comfort, communication, which makes sense with it, you know, being associated with the element of air, consecrate and bless, dedication, devotion, divination, dream work, endurance, energy, general energy and solar energy, envy, fidelity, grief, happiness, healing, jealousy, justice in legal matters, longevity, love, angel magic, messages and omens, the mind, peace, pleasure, prophecy, protection, spiritual protection, psychic ability, nice, relationships, responsibility, the senses, see magical creatures, that might be interesting, sensitivity, skills, sorrow, success, inner transformation, that's always a wonderful thing to experience. Visions, warmth, wealth, and well-being. So, wow, that's quite a bit of intentions for our sunny marigold flowers there. And, of course, along with the actual herb displayed here, a couple things you might want to consider working with when you're working with marigold are citrine stones. Those correspond with the sun. You can see they have a beautiful yellow tint to them. They are a quartz, but they're just gorgeous. You can see up against the white, hopefully, the yellow. And of course, the candles I would recommend working with, especially if you're really trying to harness the energy of the sun, would be yellow and orange. And of course, yellow is a fire color, and orange is an air color. So calendula, having the correspondences of both air and fire, these two are perfect representations. I love color magic and I love candle magic. So I'm probably going to have candles with a lot of the herbs that I show you guys here. Okay, so on to Cunningham's Encyclopedia of Magical Herbs. Marigold, gender, masculine, planet, sun, element, fire, powers, protection, prophetic dreams, legal matters, psychic powers. And, you know, psychic powers make sense with herbs that correspond to the sun. I know a lot of people think of the moon as being the be-all, end-all when it comes to psychic energy that comes from the planets. However, the sun is the great life giver. And, you know, without it, we wouldn't survive. And if you think about it, the moon's light is just reflecting the sun's light. So they both kind of go hand in hand. So, and I think too, mixing in sun herbs along with your lunar herbs when you're doing prophecy and dream work or dream pillows, any psychic enhancement work or oils or anything like that, it's good to have the sun with the moon just to balance everything out. So back to Cunningham's Encyclopedia of Magical Herbs, the magical uses for marigolds says, marigolds picked at noon when the sun is at its hottest and strongest will strengthen and comfort the heart. Garlands of marigolds strung on the doorpost stop evil from entering the house. Good to know. And scattered under the bed, they protect you while asleep and make your dreams come true, i.e. give you prophetic dreams. Especially effective in discovering a thief who has robbed you. Marigolds added to the bathwater help win the respect and admiration of everyone you meet. Now that makes sense, especially since calendula corresponds with the sun, and sun rules Leo. Leo is all about receiving respect and admiration. So it makes sense that this herb that corresponds to Leo would have that property to it. And let's see, the next little bit here on marigold is looking at the bright flowers strengthens the sight, and carried in the pocket, marigold helps justice to smell favorably upon you while in court. If a girl touches the petals of the marigold with her bare feet, she will understand the languages of the birds. That's interesting. Okay, well, that was my video on calendula, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, comments, leave them in the comment section below. Hit the like button, share, and subscribe. Bye.